Hey, this is Jason with Hoverstream, and this video is going to be a quick overview on our mold making process that we're using for the Evolution Hovercraft. First, we start with the design, all of which is done in CAD. Then we build the plug, sometimes referred to as a pattern. The plug is just a model of the final part we want to make with the addition of some flat side flanges to make the eventual production process easier. Finally, the actual mold is then built on top of the plug. The first step is design, where we figure out what we want the part to look like. I used rhinoceros to design most of the EVO parts. Once a design is ready, it needs to be made into a plug. Now, if we were a really big company with unlimited resources, we could just add flanges and send it out to a giant 5-axis gantry router to be cut from a single huge block of foam model board. Because we're a small company that can only dream about unlimited resources, we have to make do with sheets of modeling foam and a CNC router. This means figuring out how to slice the entire plug into 2-inch thick layers. And because the model board is fairly expensive, we want to do that using the minimum amount of material necessary to get the job done. Once it's all sliced up, then we design a support structure out of a lower cost material to help hold everything together and keep the whole assembly rigid. With the surface sliced up and the support structure complete, it's time to create the tool pass that the CNC router will need to actually cut the foam. For this, we use Fusion 360. After I calculate all the tool paths, I go to the router and start cutting the material to build the actual plug. After everything is done at the router, we can take the cut model board and support pieces and assemble them like a giant 3D jigsaw puzzle. Once we assemble all the pieces into the right places, we repeat a cycle of sanding and filling over and over until the plug finish is super smooth. Then we polish. It's a very labor-intensive, tedious process, but the mold, and ultimately the hovercraft part, will be an exact copy of this plug. Any flaw or imperfection in the plug will transfer to the mold and then need fixed on every single part that ever gets produced. So by spending the extra time on the plug itself, it ensures that the actual hovercraft pieces look really nice when they come out of the mold later on. Once all of the polishing is done, we seal it with a release agent so that the plug doesn't get stuck to the mold. If all goes well, the plug and the mold will basically fall apart. If things don't go well, it can be a long and painful learning experience. Once we finish with the release agent, the plug is done. It's now time to build the mold itself. To start on the mold, we spray the plug with a tooling gel coat. Tooling gel is a hard protective coating that can hold a high gloss. It's also thick enough to allow some degree of future repair. If, for example, the mold gets scratched or worn after lots of use, it could be sanded and repolished again. Gel coat is available in any color, but bright orange or black are the most common for tooling. After it's sprayed, we let the gel coat set up, typically overnight, and then we start laying the fiberglass on. This generally involves 8 to 10 layers of fiberglass mat on the back side. The ultimate thickness required will vary, but the average for us ends up being around 3/8 of an inch or 9 to 10 millimeters at the end. When the fiberglass is cured, we pop the mold away from the plug just a little bit to make sure that we'll be able to separate it easily when it's all said and done. This step is kind of like cooking a Thanksgiving turkey. There are infinite variations of rub, marinade, stuff, followed by hours of baking, frying, smoking, roasting, whatever you decide to do. But you really don't know for sure how it all turns out until you start slicing into it at the very end. And at that point, it's too late to change anything. So building a mold is just like that, but with a turkey that costs many thousands of dollars and many weeks of painstaking labor by multiple people. We've had this moment end with cheers and high fives. We've also had it end in tears, nausea, and weeks of rework. There are countless products and processes on the market for this job, but after many attempts varying from zero effort to total disaster, we finally have a formula that we think works for us. To protect the mold from damage and keep it dimensionally rigid, we design a metal frame to go around it. It gets glued and fiberglassed onto the back, non-gel coated side of the mold. Once that cures, we lift it off of the plug. The outside gets trimmed, the gel coat will get a final polish, and then we apply another sealing release agent to the mold to make sure future parts will come off easily. And with that step, we're done. The mold's now ready to start producing parts.